Do you edit videos? If you do, you are like a doctor on the war. You're given a bunch of clips, but not all of them will survive to the final cut. Some clips will be so weak they will not survive. Some will die even though they're not in such a bad shape. On the war, time means life, and nurses and doctors will label their patients. This process is called triage. The assignment of degrees of urgency to wounds or illnesses to decide the order of treatment of a large number of patients or casualties. Blacks will die and there is nothing you can do. Greens will be just fine. Reds and yellows are a little bit more complicated. They may live or die, depend on the help you can provide. You're like a triage nurse. You're the editor. And I am as well. My name is Piotr Toczyński and today I'm gonna share with you 8 useful tips for using labels in video editing to optimize your workflow. If you're new to this channel, and you are, please consider subscribing, and without further delay, let's do it. Let's say you have to edit an interview where few people answer the same question, which is quite a common scenario. The more questions they're asked, the more complicated it becomes. And using labels, you can color code each question. And everyone knows that being organized in editing is crucial. So here we have Brad and Sam, two guys who cycled from Dubai to Spain. I've met them on the camping in Albania and talked to them in front of my travel camera. I've asked them almost identical questions and edited it together, labeling each question firsthand.
Most of the time we're camping somewhere pretty close to a town.
One night we'll stay in the city, one night we'll stay out in the village, one night we'll stay in a field, one night we'll stay on the beach. It's really good to do it this way.
This tip has to do with efficiency of labeling. By default you have to right-click each clip and choose specific label, and that becomes really time-consuming. To avoid it, we assign shortcuts for labels. Open keyboard shortcuts panel and just type label. Now add numeric keys to labels. By doing so, you may override shortcuts for switching cameras in multicam workflow. But of course, you should save it as custom shortcut setup. This way, you can switch back to defaults if needed. Now I can label the timeline very quickly. Another useful option that we'll assign to keyboard shortcut as well is select label group. So type label again in keyboard shortcuts panel and I'll assign Shift+1 to it. Once again, save it to your custom shortcut setup. For example, if I need to select all answers related to Brad and Sam everyday routine, all I need to do is press Shift+1 on a given clip. You can use labels in so many different ways. You can color code shot angles with it. Wide shots can be iris blue, middle close-ups can be mango. Most of the time the way you can label things depends on the project and what you can accomplish with it. But all of the time you can find it helpful. You can also label bins and clips in project panel. So you can color code your project before you take clips to the timeline. Premiere Pro treats clips as separate instances, so when you change a label for a given clip in project panel, it does not reflect on the timeline, unless you check one checkbox in general project settings. Press display the project item name and label color for all instances. Now it will update itself each time you change the label. Waveforms can inherit clip labels or be treated separately. To tweak this, you need to check or uncheck audio waveforms use label color. Another thing you can do is pre-specify label defaults in preferences. Just go to preferences, labels. Now you can assign yellow to video, blue to audio, teal to still and so on. It works for new items imported to the project. I also have the bonus tip for you. Let's say you cooperate on the cut with another editor and you want to make it easier for them to work on your project. In the preferences, you can name what given label stands for in projects panel. So for example, Rose is the shot for further compositing for motion graphic artist. You can rename all the labels and now it will be clear for another editor. Being a video editor is like being a triage nurse. Fate of any clip depends on you. So let the force be with you. Though I'm not a huge Star Wars fan, to be honest, please tell me how you use labels in your editing workflow. If you don't, let me know if this video convinced you to do it. It was Piotr, see you in the next Premiere Pro video, when I'm gonna find a needle in a haystack. Stay tuned, and I'm out.